Only on the day I decide to film my best of skincare will I get a breakout, because such is life. Even though it's December, it's not even a little bit cold in Bombay. Not even a little bit. Hi my loves, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video of the final rundown of Vlogmas 2020. And for today's video, I'm sharing my best of skincare 2020 with y'all. This year has been, touch wood, alhamdulillah, really good for my skin, in fact, because I was trying so many things but I did not get so many reactions. Ekada hue the definitely, but it still performed much better. And this was finally the year that I weaned off of my PCOS medications and my skin still did not react. So touch wood, really good. All of y'all touch wood right now, touch wood, okay? Fine. Now let's dive into this. I have my best skincare of 2020 to share with y'all, and I always sit bare-faced for my skincare videos so y'all can see ke kya ho raha hai, kaisa chal raha hai, you know, hal chal kaise hai skin ke and everything. So if this is the first time you've come here, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. So please take a moment, hit the subscribe button, join the Sarah squad. Also click the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. With that, let's dive into the best skincare of 2020. So when I was planning this video out, I was thinking, how do I want to categorize this? Do I want to do face washes, moisturizers and stuff, or do I want to do nighttime, daytime? So I thought I'll do daytime, nighttime skincare routine separately so that you all also know ke when did I actually enjoy using these products. So first, starting with my favorite daytime skincare routine products. For cleanser, I have thoroughly enjoyed, and probably you all have also seen that I have enjoyed using the Dermaweave Hydra Cleanser. If you see my vlogs, if you see my day-to-day routine on Instagram and stuff, I use this cleanser literally every morning when I wake up. First thing I really like about this is that it's really gentle on your face. It is soap-free as well as fragrance-free. So at night, I do have a lot of like moisture collection, sebum collection from, of course, sleeping over. But also, I don't want to like wake up and feel like sab nikal diya skin pe se. Like, I don't want to feel too dry. So this is exactly the cleanser for me. It does not like rip my skin too much. It is very gentle on the skin and it has no like scrub beads or anything. It's very, very gentle. It lathers up just the right amount. Since it's soap free, it does not lather too much also. Bahut zyada jhag nahi hota hai, but it's just the perfect amount, okay? So I really, really like this cleanser and it definitely has been a hit of 2020 for me. So after cleansing my face, I used to go in with a serum, and I used to use the Myoho Pure by Priyanka serum literally for 2/3 of this year. I've only used this vitamin C serum. There is very little left in this bottle. I absolutely loved and enjoyed using this. It is 15% vitamin C, so it's strong, it does the job, it helps my skin really look nice, bright and glowy. Of course, the effects of vitamin C I will not be able to see now in the short term. It will show up more in long term. But the best part that I like about this vitamin C is that it suits my skin, because a lot of vitamin C serum don't suit my skin and give me breakouts, but this particular one did not do that. I currently only use it like thrice a week in the mornings. If I'm not using this, I'm either using nothing as a serum or I'm using another special mention. I will tell y'all at the end of, like, after we're done with morning and night time, there are certain special mentions for the video. So yeah, this is definitely a hit from my side. I also have a code with them. Wherever I have codes, I will leave them on the screen or in the description section. So make sure to use them if you're shopping, because that helps me out and keeps the channel moving, y'all. Next, for moisturizer, I have of course loved using the Nutriderm Vitamin E Moisturizing Lotion. Legit use this every single morning because it's very lightweight. It is not heavy throughout the day for me. It is just the perfect amount of moisturization that keeps me going, that I don't feel the need to apply moisturizer again and again, and also it's not too sticky or greasy. So if I'm applying makeup, it's the perfect like pre-makeup base where my skin is already prepped, and if I'm not applying makeup also, like right now, so I just have this on my face and I have my sunscreen, so it's the perfect combination. In the morning, I just use this and then I go in with my sunscreen, which is the next hit of 2020, and that is the UV Duo SPF 50 sunscreen. Enjoyed and loved using this. My dermat actually introduced me to this sunscreen and I love the finish of it. It's my second tube and it is like a complete matte finish. Like, if you apply this, you will not feel it at all. Like, it just sinks into your skin. No greasy, no chip chip. You don't sweat it out. Aisa paseena hota hai, and then you start like accumulating sunscreen. Aisa kuch nahi hota hai usse. And it's perfect. And it's SPF 50. You have to like keep reapplying it. That reapplying bit is where I know we all get lazy. So do I. I'm gonna like admit to it. But yeah, it works really well, and I think it's a very, very good sunscreen. If you're oily skin type, you would love it. I'm oily skin type, in case I forgot to mention, I have an oily skin, so I prefer such matte sunscreens. Moving on to nighttime skincare routines. Now, I've preferably kept my nighttime skincare a little simpler because I was using some medicated products, like prescription based products, in my nighttime skincare routine. So it's fairly simple. The first product I was using as cleanser at night was the Dr. Shade's Basic Brightening Daily Cleanser. Lost the cap to this also because I love this one. Iska bhi aadha ho chuka hai. The texture of this is very unique. It has some beads in it, so at the end of the day, whatever gunk is there from my skin, it just like really cleanses it really, really well without ripping my skin off its natural layer and natural oils. The beads in it are not scrub beads, don't get me wrong. It's formulated in a way that you feel that you don't feel the texture of the beads, but I think they are like the rosehip seed extract, which is there. They formulated it in like capsulated amounts and put it in like a base. That's how most of Dr. Shade's products, if you see the texture of it, it's mostly like a base product, and then they have capsulated forms of the main ingredient in them. So that's how it is formulated, and I really like this face wash. You can also use code SARA20 on the Dr. Shade's website and you will get a 20% off their entire website. So yeah, bear that in mind. Then for serum at nighttime, I usually like to go with the Eclat Fade Out Serum. This has niacinamide as well as azelaic acid, which was great for my acne scarring. Worked really well to like fade my acne scars. It's slower in action, but I'm in no hurry to like let my acne marks go. It's fine if it's slow, but it is doing the job, and I really, really like it. I do more of a spot treatment with this because along with this I use my prescription based medication, but yeah, I really, really like this product and highly recommend it. If you are facing acne marks or burn marks or any marks, basically, or hyperpigmentation, it will also take care of that. Lastly, for moisturization at nighttime, I have enjoyed, like thoroughly enjoyed, using the Dr. Shade's Multitasking Miracle Cream. Oh my god, this is my second tub. Very rarely do I run out of moisturizers, okay, because moisturizer I use bahut kam. Because I'm oily skin, I don't like to overload on moisturizer. That's why Nutriderm bhi abhi tak khatam nahi hua hai. This is like, first toh bahut kam milta hai, not gonna lie, you get very less product in this for the price of it. It's a little expensive. It's I think 1200 for this tub, if I'm not wrong, and it is a little expensive, but it is so good. The main ingredients in this are hyaluronic acid for plumping and amino acids for repairing and lipopeptides for anti-aging. I think it's a great moisturizer for all skin types because it has a very nice creamy base, but at the same time it's like just sinks into your skin, feels nourishing, feels really, really good, and also hydrates the skin really well. Especially in a weather like Bombay, where you don't know what kind of weather you're facing. You're sometimes transitioning, sometimes in winter. The winter is so short-lived. This kind of a moisturizer is an all-season one, which is why I like it so much, and definitely love this one and highly recommend. So this was my morning and nighttime skincare routine for most of 2020, which is of course the products I thoroughly enjoyed. And now I have some special mentions, some special serums and masks that I enjoyed using here and there when I was not using these products. So first special mention I have is the Earth Rhythm Phyto Gel. This is the Centella Asiatica and Horsetail Extract Moisturizer. It's supposed to be, basically, I use it as a moisturizer. So on the days I don't want to use these two moisturizers, I prefer using this. I basically enjoy using this when my skin is very irritated, like it's very red, or if I have a lot of like acne bursting out from different places, or some pustule acnes or some deep ones, you know, like bahut skin irritated hair, like before my period and stuff, or during my period, that is when I reach out to this and only use this because it's really gentle and calming for my skin and calms down my skin's general irritation. So I've loved using this one for those special days. Then my blackhead savior has been the Dr. Shade's Neem and BHA serum. Really like using this on my nose as like a weekly mask, and also sometimes on those pustulated pimples that you get, you know, those pus filled pimples, one or two you get here and there. That is where I just use it as a spot treatment, keep it on like for the whole night as spot treatment, or I use it as a 10 minute overall face mask and wash it off, like 10 or 5 minutes, sometimes even 5 minutes. But basically enjoyed using this, takes care of my blackheads and those pimples here and there really well. Once a week I'm definitely using this one, so I had to mention it. Then on the days that my skin was dull, dry, I needed a real pick-me-up, the Earth Rhythm Glow Serum was a total love at first sight, because this serum gives you a boost of glow like instantly. Like with skincare, of course you have to use it quite a lot to see results, and you have to use it more consistently. This product I use very inconsistently. I don't use it every day, or I don't even recommend you use it every day because it has a lot of actives in it. But when I was not using the Myoho Pure by Priyanka one, I told you all, this is the one I was using because this also has vitamin C 20%. But along with that, it has salicylic acid, hyaluronic acid and retinol in it. So on the days that my skin really needed something to like you know, feel alive. This is the serum I reached out for, and so I absolutely love this one. I have a code with Earth Rhythm, so if you're shopping on their website, you can use the code Sara and you'll get a 10% off their entire website. Another special mention to this absolutely stunning face mask that I enjoyed using, it's by Plum. This is a chamomile and white tea face mask. Really like this one. It adds a boost of glow again. Like if you want to go for a wedding, I didn't go for any weddings in 2020. Nobody invited me to their wedding in 2020, letting you all know that. But if you want to go like for a date night or something, date night bhi thi nahi waise. क्या बोल रही हूँ मैं 2020 में ऐसा कुछ था नहीं एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी बट जब भी यू फील माई डेट्स वर विथ योर ओनली ऑन कैमरा वेन एवर आई फेल्ट लाइक आई नीड अ पिक मी अप फॉर अ वीडियो दिस इज अ फेस मास्क आई अप्लाइड इट आई वॉश्ड माई फेस एंड माई स्किन वॉज इंस्टेंटली ग्लोइंग इट्स अ इंस्टेंट पिक मी अप एंड माई मॉम यूजेज इट लिटरली वंस अ वीक बिकॉज शी रियली रियली लाइक्स इट वॉट इट डज टू अर स्किन इट सेज इट्स फॉर नॉर्मल ड्राई एंड कॉम्बिनेशन स्किन एंड आई डू अग्री बिकॉज माई स्किन इज ऑयली वेर एज माई मॉम्स इज लाइक कॉम्बिनेशन स्किन सो या इट सूट्स बोथ ऑफ आर स्किन एंड वी बोथ हैव रियली enjoyed using this face mask. The makeup remover that had it this year for me has to be the Earth Rhythm Cleansing Jelly. Loved this one. Like if you are looking for a good cleansing milk or a cleansing balm, look no further. This is a real good one. You don't have to invest in a very expensive one. This is affordable and it is so good. It melts all of your makeup. This is the one with pink pomelo extract. I don't think it has any extra coloring because it does not tint my skin at all, but it looks pink and there is no extra fragrance at all. To be very honest, Earth Rhythm ke saath jo bhi I've tried na till now, I've really enjoyed it. Like there's no product I've received from them that I've felt like it's not up to the mark or what is this, you know, what are they doing or like it's a gimmick or something. Every single product either blows my socks or it's like good, it's not bad. And this particular product really blew my socks. It's really good, takes off all your makeup, does not strip your skin, and is like you need very little and it will melt your makeup like a dream. And the next makeup remover that I enjoyed using is the Clinique Take the Day Off makeup remover. This is the makeup remover and not the makeup like the balm. Of course the balm is also really good, I do have it, but since I love the cleansing jelly, honestly I love the cleansing jelly more than I love the Clinique Take the Day Off balm, this particular Take the Day Off makeup remover is so good. It's an oil and water mixed one and it is genuinely like it takes away even my waterproof mascara, and no amount of makeup removers, even if they claim to do so, have done that ever for me. Nobody can take off my waterproof mascara and this one does it. So it's hands down the best makeup remover I have tried and really like this one. For lip balm, the lip balm I've used the most and enjoyed using the most this year is the Sebamed SPF 15 Lip Defense. I really like this one. My dermat actually asked me to use this. I was facing a lot of lip issues this year. I also got laser done for my lips this year, which is why I had to switch to something like this, which has SPF, which has no color in it and not tinted at all. So every 2 hours, I'm literally moisturizing my lips. Every 2 minutes, I moisturize my lips because my lips dry out really quickly, and this lip balm has been a savior and really one of my favorites. That was all I had for skincare, and of course now I'm going to mention my hair care. I did my worst of hair care yesterday, so I want to do my best of hair care today. The shampoo that is legit the only shampoo I use is this one right here from OGX, the Argan Oil of Morocco shampoo. It's a nice and big bottle. I literally only use this shampoo, nothing else. It keeps my hair really like moisturized and clean and nice, and you need very little of this and it does the job. I have tried so many shampoos in the past and nothing agrees with me, especially because my hair is curly and frizzy. It does not agree with me very readily. This particular shampoo, absolutely love it. And if you have curly hair, dry hair, dehydrated hair, I highly recommend you try this one. Then a special shout out to the Wella hair mask. This is the Invigo Color Brilliance with Lime Caviar. Really, really like this hair mask. Since I colored my hair this year, I was looking for a hair mask or a hair shampoo or something that basically makes my hair color look a little more vibrant, because my hair color is not very obvious. It's a balayage and it's fading away right now, though it's faded away, but when the sunlight hits it does look a lot more vibrant. So when I tried this hair mask out, I had a tester of it and I tried it and it was so good. It moisturizes my hair. It also, because I have curly hair, it hydrates my curls and keeps them really nice and bouncy. At the same time, when I use this, my color looks so popping and so nice. So I really, really, really like this hair mask. And finally, the hair serum that had my heart this year has to be the L'Oreal Extraordinary Oil Serum. I was sent this product and can you see how much I've used? Like never have I ever used a serum so much itna jaldi. Like abhi aaya tha meko PR mein and itna jaldi I've used it. I love it. I absolutely love it. I use it as a heat protectant before and after I blow dry my hair. Even like after I blow dry it, even to maintain my blow dry, I keep using it. Even if I want to tame flyaways away, I use it. It has a very unique and nice texture where it's oil based and it like nourishes my hair, but at the same time it tames away frizz, does not feel sticky, it's lightweight, it has really really good claims and it holds up to every single one of them. So I absolutely love this one. And with that, we complete the best skin and hair care of 2020. This was all the skin and hair care products that I thoroughly enjoyed using this year. Sound off in the comments and let me know if you had any of these skincare or hair care products in your routine, or which was the skincare or hair care product that changed your skin this year or your hair this year. I want to know in the comments so I can go ahead and try it out. If you did actually like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Kritika Madan. Thank you so much, Kritika, for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, all you gotta do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, take care, I love you. Mwah.